She just holds it. And when that happened, my God, what do you think the sound of the stadium was? Make the noise that you think the sound of the stadium sounded. The stadium went absolutely crazy because here she just landed on a broken ankle. And it's something that's gonna go down in the history of Olympics. And she sits there, collapses, her coach comes running out to her, her teammates come running out, they're hugging her, they're jumping at her, they're all in tears. Next thing you know, the Russian team comes running over to her and begins to hug her and embrace her, because even the enemy has to get inspired. Come on. Jesus was trying to get us to understand that when you begin to understand all that you are capable of doing, the Russian teams is running over, everybody's running, the stadium is full of tears, everybody crying around, everybody's in tears, the commentators are going crazy, the judges put up the score, 9.1, 9.8, 9.7, for the very first time, the women's U.S. gymnast team won gold. In over half a century, it hasn't happened. But they won gold because of one 20-year-old who had the faith, who had that level of certainty, and knew that that year was their year. That year was going to be the year that the U.S. takes this thing home, and that we take home gold. And I truly believe that that was Jesus who was doing this. When he came and we're reading about this, he came for those 3 years to help you understand that if you raise your standard, that if you operate at a different standard, that if you raise your own level of expectation, that if you operate at a higher level, that you expect more out of you, that if you expect more out of yourself, that you start doing things that will blow your mind, that even your enemies would have to come and join you. Join your mission, hallelujah. And so listen, you may say, well, I don't have that skill set. I don't have the special abilities. I'm not an athlete. You may even say, well, I don't have purpose. You saying that is slapping your creator in the face. And it's slapping Jesus in the face because he went to the cross for you. Yes. He went to the cross for your purpose. He went to the cross so that you can accelerate his kingdom, so that you can recognize all that is possible when you believe.